pre-workout, we're gonna have some quick carbs. Some mashed potatoes that I annihilated a couple minutes prior.
This is not an honest review because I've already had this quite a couple times. Fuck this. That shit's gas. So, taste wise. The flavor is pink lemonade. The taste is a 7.5 out of 10. Last year's tasted better, but the thing is that this one works 10 times better than the one last year. But the one last year tasted like Minute Maid lemonade, pink lemonade. This one does not as much. It does taste it. There's a tinge of it, but it's just not as strong as it used to be, taste-wise. Performance-wise, this one is... I've never had a better working pre in my life. And the aftertaste tastes like iced tea, I'm not gonna lie. And it's not chalky, not doesn't make you wanna like cry or force drink it. It's comfortable to drink, but it's not like you're not drinking it like juice per se.
I'm in need of a banana for some more carbohydrates before my little workout. I think we're working out with Ryan today. It's gonna be tough. We're hitting a nice little workout. Pull day, bicep, back, butt.
Around like that instead of below, so that I just feel it in my last lap.
Gotcha.
You twist your arms in like that, so instead of like that, tucked in. Just go through that motion. Up here, go squeeze. You can go up fast, and then on the back way down, fight it.
Time for some strength test again.
Don't.
Damn. So, hey, as you can tell, I shaved my pride, my honor, my everything. Just kidding. Shaved my mustache. It feels so weird.
I want to help you guys real quick.
Some of y'all want to change other people, so you might not like something that they're doing. You might want them to do this and that. One of my stories on this is with my dad. He would, back when I was younger, every single day from first grade to fifth grade, my dad would every single day check over my homework and make sure I'm getting everything right, you know, making sure like I did my homework. And
back then I had dreams to be a pro soccer player. So I kind of threw all that out the window. I didn't bother trying in school. I had really bad grades, I'm not gonna lie. It was on a scale of 1 to 4. I would have twos and a couple threes, rarely would I have a four. And he was trying to drill it into my head to do good in school because he wanted me to be a doctor. He was kind of like, he was forcing me to like get good grades, which isn't the wrong thing to do. You know, you would want your kids to get good grades in school so that they have a job where they can in the future provide for their family. Because my dad didn't grow up rich at all. He immigrated from Ukraine to the US so that me and my family could have a better, you know, life. So he wants me to do the same for my kids. He wants me to give them opportunity for them to live comfortably. So he kind of forced me to do good in school, and I just didn't. I was so reluctant to do so. I was so set on being a soccer player. And then he'd come back home at like 10 o'clock, and then for like 2 hours every single night, he'd just go over homework. You know, he would prepare me for tests. He'd take time out of his day trying to like tell me do this, do that. And I just didn't want to listen, just didn't care. And then over time, his job forced him to work even later. My dad comes back home late. So he was kind of forced to not be able to check over my homework. This was sixth grade now. And during that summer period, I kind of snapped out of the whole I want to be a pro soccer player type thing. I didn't give up on it. I wasn't like, oh, I hate soccer. It was just, I don't want to like do that in the future in terms of job-wise. And I was like, the chances of me being a pro soccer player, making that big money is so slim. It's like slim to none. So I kind of lost my passion for becoming a pro. I still enjoy playing it, but becoming a pro is just not on any of my lists. So I kind of snapped out of it, and I was like, dang, wait, if I want to provide for my family, I got to get a decent job. So maybe I should start doing good in school. So I did just that, and what happened was my dad, during that period of where like this happened, like where I was like, dang, I gotta start doing good in school if I wanna have a decent future, you know, provide for my family, you know, let my future family live comfortably. The way that happened was that my dad gave me space. He was forced to not be able to check my homework, and this just let me be on my own and be solo. He would nudge me like every here and there being like, yo, do good in school, but he just couldn't do anything though. He wouldn't check over anything. He'd check my report cards, but he wouldn't actually check over my work anymore. Or like sit with me at 10 o'clock at night checking all my like homework. So this space that he gave me allowed me for myself to like think for myself without having someone like putting their 2 cents into me and telling me do this, do that. I kind of on my own changed. And I started doing good in school. Like back then, if I got a feeling grade, I'd be so okay with it. I'd be like, I don't really care. Now it's kind of like, I gotta have like a decent grade. And what I kind of learned from that is I look back on that. That's kind of like God working in my life and teaching me a lesson. Teaching me, the lesson I want you guys to pull out of this is that you cannot force someone to do something out of your own wanting them to do something. You can always imply stuff. You can let them know. But what they decide to do is up to them. Same thing goes with every situation known to man. Prime example would also be like religion.
A lot of people want to force their religion on you, even though maybe it's the right thing to do. Like, I'm a Christian person. Like, me sharing the gospel, me sharing the word of God is not a bad thing. But I can't tell someone, yo, be a Christian. Like the Crusaders back in the day. As cool as I think it is, like, them going to war for, like, their religion and, like, fighting with swords and shit, it's not the right thing to do. Like, they didn't accomplish jack shit. They lost. In the end, they lost, bro. Like, it's now Istanbul. It's not even Constantinople. This is low-key the outro. I filmed this like a day later on like an actual camera.
Damn, no mustache. That's wild.
So yeah, thank you guys for watching. Please like, comment. If you're not subscribed, subscribe. Like, why the fuck not? I make cool ass content. I make decent content. Y'all should give all my other videos a watch too. Yeah, when y'all like and comment, the algorithm pushes my shit to other people. So I mean, if y'all want to support.
Individuals dropping some new stuff too as well. Don't be afraid to check that out. DM me about like any information, this and that. Thank y'all for watching. See ya.